Hello everyone and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and we are jumping back into part two of my offseason here with my UMass Minutemen Dynasty. We are going to get the rest of offseason taken care of, and then I'm going to try to make the move bringing this roster into NCAA 14 so we can continue them with the newer game, the game that's more fun to play. Gameplay-wise, and as far as UMass goes, they've got all sorts of different new uniform sets that they have in real life that have been added to the game that weren't in NCAA 13, so there's lots of incentive to bring them over to the new game, and it just plays better. It's a better game, so obviously we want to do that. So we left off right about here when we were looking at position changes. So what we're going to do first is jump in here and look and see what we can do first and foremost with those recruits that are labeled athletes that basically can be sculpted into whatever you want. But we want to make sure that we get them in positions that will favor them. So we go and look at our athlete list, and we have five of them. We've got J.J. Gilliam. We've got Drew Barber. We have Kyle Bailey, we have Trey Stevens, and we have Jason Jones. So all these guys need to be fit into a position and to see where they fit best. So let's go do that right now. We'll be back here once we've got them in positions, and we'll go over where each one is going to be playing. Okay, let's give a quick rundown of where everybody went here. A couple of these guys went to an already stacked wide receiver position, including J.J. Gilliam, I put there. I also put Jason Jones there. Yeah, so that's what we got for wide receivers. Okay, I also made Drew Barber a corner. He'll be a 75 overall there. We turned Trey Stevens into a free safety for the time being. And Kyle Bailey has become a strong safety, trying to even these guys out so that they all don't go to one position. Okay, that's going to be it for the position changes. There may have been one or two minor move arounds that I did to even out the line for guys who were already here on the roster. Nothing else huge change there. We're going to advance to the next stage now. Now we get to find out the training results. This is big here because we get to see just how well our returning players have progressed here and if they will be able to fend off the freshmen for starting positions. Let's see what we got for training results in a national championship season. Okay, Ronnie Houston leads the list. He is now a 92 and our best and highest overall rated player. Ronnie Houston, a 92. Now, I said yesterday, I took a guess that Joel Meadows would become an 89. I was wrong. He actually breaks the 90s there. He will be a 90 overall as a junior. Can you imagine if he stays in school for his senior year? He is bound to be a 94, 95 overall player, and some of you still want me to sit him. Somebody said in the comments yesterday, go find a better replacement for Joel Meadows. He was already an 85 at the time. He is now a 90. Come on, guys. Got to give it up. Joel Meadows is here to stay as the quarterback until he either enters the draft or he graduates. Andy Chase is now an 88 overall, as is kicker extraordinaire Wendell Patton. Let's see, Patton is a senior. This will be his last year, so we'll have to be mindful of the kicking duties behind him as he leaves. Steve Matthews, left guard, now an 87 overall. Corey Harvey, who really has not cracked the lineup much yet at all, just spot duty. I know some of you at certain points asked for more playing time for Corey Harvey. Well, he gets it this year. He's an 87 overall. Alex Dennis, 87. Ross Reed, 87. Randy Smith goes to 86. Steve Coleman, in just his sophomore year, bounces up to 86, a plus 5. Wes Collins is going to be an 85 at backup quarterback. How about that? David Smith, an 85 at D-tackle. Right tackle, Freddie Charles, 85. Mike Elliott at center, 85. As a plus 6, that's very nice. Ben Burch, he did work, and he goes a plus 5 here overall to an 84. Chris Hills, 84. Rashad Green, 84. Eric Holmes, yep, going right on down the line here. Robert Vincent steps up to an 84, a plus 6 from his 78 rating. I wonder what his counterpart, his other buddy at halfback did. We'll have to see when we get to him here. There he is, Dustin Jones, right behind him at an 83. But it looks like Robert Vincent will be that starter. All right, we're just going to quickly go through here with the rest of this. We've got, look at that. Never mind, we don't have to go anywhere for a kicker next year. We've got an 82 overall. Jonathan Ross ready to take over. He's a junior redshirt, so he'll only have him for 1 year kicking. Assuming Patton does a kicking duty, we'll have to see where Patton stands as a place kicker still. Just kind of rifling through here. Man, look at all these players over 80. We've come a long way with this roster. A long way. We have two very little used tight ends. Now, Reed got used. He caught a touchdown in the championship game, actually. But not heavily used, at least in the passing game. He's an 80 now. Aaron Jones is an 80. Stokes is only a 79, and he was the one we relied on the most. Now, we've got a freshman coming in that tops all these guys. Lance Fletcher. Okay, so we're into the 70s now with these guys. And we do have a punter on board, too. So I guess we're pretty good at those positions. All right, that is your training results. It is now time to advance to the next stage. And that will be where we cut players. This is going to be much more difficult this year. Here we are in the cut players stage. This should get interesting this year, my goodness. We've been cutting more and more upperclassmen that just didn't make the mark here after bringing in much better talent. But we are 10 people over our final roster size. So we're going to have to go position by position here and see what we can do. I think this is where we need to cut. I think George Franklin is our first casualty here to go. What do we got going on at the left end position? Two seniors. Sophomore, two freshmen. And a junior that's never really going to see the field. He gets cut. Right end now. All sophomores. Couple redshirt sophomores. These guys are all going to graduate at the same time. Yeah. It's not like somebody's walking out the door tomorrow. Can't believe we're cutting 77 overall people, but I think we might just be doing it there. D tackle. Okay, sophomore, junior. Sophomore. Junior redshirt. Junior redshirt. I think we gotta trim down one there. Go with four. This is a junior redshirt that isn't going to get a whole lot better. He'll crack into the 80s, but he's not going to start. So I think we cut him loose. You've got a sophomore who's already redshirted. I think we sadly have to let an 80 overall go. Just because we don't have as much time with him. I think we actually have to cut the 82 overall kicker. Sorry, Jonathan Ross. I think we need to cut the junior redshirt. Because the freshman's got potential to at least get up there. He'll be around here longer. I just don't think Henry is going to fit in. They call him a bust. I said he's still pretty good as a bust at 76 overall, but he still is just not going to crack this roster. Sorry. Right end, sophomore redshirt Nicholas Gonzalez. He's going to be the last cut. There we go. We've gotten down to 70 players. Whew, that was not easy. It was a lot harder. It was a lot more cut and dry in years before. Let's advance to the next stage. Now we've reached the spot of custom conferences. Now, we'll have to do this over in NCAA 14 anyway. So I don't know if I'm going to even mess with this right now. I have considered a move to the SEC. A couple people have hinted that that would be a good idea. Obviously, I'd like to take a step up in conference play, make that harder. And hey, we won the national championship. We were only in the ACC 1 year, but I think maybe we'll move to the SEC this year. That's what I'm leaning towards. So here we are in preseason 2017, and they've disrespected us. They've put us at number 10 in the nation coming in here. Apparently they don't think we can repeat. How about that? Well, the next thing to do is to set up the recruiting board, which makes no sense to do here since this will be in a brand new game here in NCAA 14. As well as redshirting players, you get to do all this when you start a new season over there. So I think this is about as far as we can go here in the old game. It is now time for me to make a spreadsheet or figure out whatever I'm going to do to get these guys in to NCAA 14. That is my task to continue this series. Hopefully we can figure it out and get it over. Now, the last thing to talk about, and I want to get some feedback from you guys, as far as our coach Junk Johnson goes, he's obviously built up a lot of respect and prestige, I guess, when it comes to recruiting, when it comes to his job security, all of that. Now, there is a new system in place in NCAA 14 for coaching, and it basically revolves around the coaches' points that they earn. So I definitely don't think Junk Johnson should be a zero coming in. What level do you think Junk Johnson has earned coming into NCAA 14 as far as his points? I mean, is he up there with the best coaches in the nation? Does he still have quite a bit to prove? Where would you rank him on the new system, those of you that have played NCAA 14, how many points would you allow him coming into the new game? Because that's something that is definitely going to have to be looked at. He's at an A-plus prestige and 100% job security. His prestige ranks at an A-plus after 5 years. You see his record 45-21. Had some struggles early on, obviously. But that is what we're looking at. So we're going to have to decide a level for him coming in as well, so we can debate that in the comments here. That'd be great. So that's going to put a wrap on the off season. The next video you'll see in this series will hopefully, knock on wood, be in NCAA 14. So that's what we're shooting for. Hopefully we can get that accomplished. Come on back for more UMass football. We'll see you very soon, guys.